Good morning. I'm Dr. Dumisani Quiet Mabunda. I'm from the University of South Africa, the College of Law, Police Practice Department. I'm here to present something about the role of traditional leadership in policing, focusing in the areas of Limpopo, the Giani and Malamulele area. The challenge that we are having in South Africa is that this century-old custom of traditional initiation schools seems to be going out of hand. Children are dying, children are maimed. We have all sorts of illegal traditional initiation schools. So I'm here to present something that will help the police as well as the traditional leadership to continue with this custom in a safe environment. What we have found in my studies while I was doing my PhD 2 years ago is that there is no communication or relationship between the traditional leadership and the police, and police are not allowed to investigate crime in these situations. Parents are only notified of their children who have passed on in these traditional initiation schools long after they have been buried, and there's a violation of human rights and all sorts of challenges. So my studies helps to bring all the parties together so that this practice can be continued in a safe environment. The area where this problem is prevalent is in the area of the Eastern Cape in South Africa, where children are abducted without the knowledge of the parents, problems of extortion, because once the children have been taken to these initiation schools, monies are demanded from parents so that the children can be released. There is no kind of regulation. I think it's a noble custom that needs to be continued, because studies that I've conducted have also found that most of these sexually transmitted diseases are minimized because children have gone to these traditional initiation schools. But the problem is that even if a child has been taken to a medical circumcision, because of peer pressure, this child, this young boy, will be regarded as a boy, regardless of the age, if that child has not gone to the initiation school. So it puts so much pressure to the children and the parents as well. So they run to this school so that they can be accepted in society. So that is the basis of my study, and I've seen improvement while talking to traditional leadership, guiding them how they should work hand in hand with the police, and the police also work with this traditional leadership. So that is the only way in which this century-old tradition can be practiced in a very, very safe environment. So that's my contribution for this presentation in this University of Lincoln. So that's what I can say at this stage.